Imagine every time a heavy rain rolls in, you're at the mercy of Mother Nature, hoping this one doesn't flood your home. That is the constant fear residents at one mobile home park in Pinellas County are living with every day.
And ABC Action News reporter Vanessa Ariza first exposed this problem when she spoke with residents back in November after Hurricane Eta left its mark on that community. And in this Full Circle report, she goes back to that community and takes a deeper dive, searching for answers as to what's causing the flooding and how it can be fixed.
Hurricane Eta roared up the west coast of Florida in November. The storm hitting the Twin Cities Mobile Home Park is a tropical storm. The rain may have passed, but the fear and concerns it brought remains months later.
I just kept watching the water go higher and higher.
Erin Roth and her daughter evacuated their home before Eta hit. And this is why. Rising waters forced people out of their homes and fire rescue into the streets.
Flooded quite constantly, but it was never as bad as what this last storm did.
The problem is the drainage system, or lack of an efficient one.
This is the only drainage area that you have in the park.
Yes, but those two green ones don't drain.
Over the years, Erin has contacted the management company, which has changed hands multiple times, but she says her concerns have fallen on deaf ears.
And they just tell us that they're working on it.
How long have they been telling you that they're working on it?
Each different owner and management, 11 years.
In fact, in the time we worked to gather information for this story, a new owner has taken over the park. Treehouse Communities now has ownership of Twin Cities. Claire Parker is their spokesperson. She declined an on-camera interview, but in an email said, quote, "The park has long experienced water management issues following heavy rain." She went on to say they have hired engineers to assess the problem and are pouring more than $100,000 to fix everything from residents' homes to the amenities. The problem isn't the sole responsibility of the new mobile home park owners. The drainage problem at the very end of this ditch is just one aspect. The Florida Department of Transportation, Pinellas County Government, as well as Goodwill Industries, which neighbor this park, all share a piece of the problem.
It's been over a year that our facilities department has been working with officials and trying to seek a solution.
Chris Ward with Goodwill Industry says the organization has hired their own set of engineers. They assess the 100 yards of drainage they share with the mobile home park. And while it did appear clogged, clearing it won't alleviate the problem.
And I'm sure it's very frustrating. I can imagine it's quite frustrating, and it looks like nobody's doing anything. But we are trying to find a solution.
Another set of engineers were sent to the area by FDOT. A representative with them echoed Goodwill's engineer team. Clogged drains. But Blake Lyon with Pinellas County says there's another factor that is causing the flooding.
This area will continue, despite all the drainage improvements, will continue to have some flooding impacts because of the location.
Lyon pointed out the mobile home park and its neighbors are in a low-lying flood-prone area. The county's floodplain ordinance requires the homes be elevated at 10 feet or above the base flood elevation, or BFE. The BFE for this property is 9 feet. Homes like Erin's were grandfathered in. To raise it to current standards, she would have to dig into her own pocket to fix it.
$2,000 or more dollars worth of stuff thrown away.
She doesn't have the funds to do that, and moving isn't an option.
What do you do next?
I have no idea. Hope and pray for the best.
A request that is at the mercy of engineers and Mother Nature. In Pinellas County, Vanessa Ariza, ABC Action News.